and the playoff intensity can be felt as the starting lineups conclude. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back momentarily with the NBA playoffs. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Game 1. 2K Sports presents the playoffs of the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan. We've got Steve Smith and Greg Anthony at the table with me. And the fourth member of our crew, David Aldridge, our sideline reporter. DA, take it away.
Well, if you ask Karl Anthony Towns, his greatest strength is his versatility. He said, "My dad taught it to me at a young age, and it's made my transition at every step of my career comfortable, having the fundamentals and foundation. I don't limit myself. I try to be great at all skills." Kevin?
Yeah, terrific attitude. It makes him very tough to handle. David, thank you. Here are the starters for Los Angeles. Hunter down low at four with Harrell in the middle. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. And it's George in at the small forward spot. And for Minnesota, Conley and Towns, the duo inside. The tandem at the one and the two, Teague and Culver. And it's Covington in at the three spot. It'll be Los Angeles off the tip. Beverly, the pass to Harrell. Back to Beverly. Outside, George. Just five to shoot. From downtown, drains the three-pointer.
And there's never been any question about George's three-point range. He just goes through stretches where he knocks down the three at a ridiculous rate.
Pass to Culver. Out of bounds, Timberwolves ball as Minnesota keeps possession. Six to shoot. From six away. Good.
And to me, guys, this is an area that Culver should utilize more often, showing off that incredible feel with the jumper.
From D, George. It doesn't go for him. And Minnesota now the other way. Outside Covington. He kicks it to Culver. Outside, Towns. Beverly against T. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And as you would expect from the way he plays, Teague is a terrific free throw shooter.
Minnesota shooting their first free throws here tonight.
Two shots.
First free throw is good. And so T gets two free throws. LA's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Beverly feeling it out a bit. Goes up the baseline, and it's Leonard missing.
You expect him to make that, especially from that distance.
Now, here's Culver. Passes to Vonleh from the low block, and he makes that one.
How about some recognition from Culver? Terrific at realizing when the defense has broken down.
There's the pass to Williams. Outside left. Teardrop shot. Was shot off that time.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it.
And Teague knew that he would be open there. Great patience and vision from the point.
Here's Williams. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
Puts it up there for Harrell, and Harrell slams it in.
I love the patience Beverly has developed with the ball in his hands. Terrific find.
Pass to Culver. Now Towns. Great D that time from Harrell. And here's Beverly. On the wing, Williams. Down low. And it's Leonard missing.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
And then Culver with the dunk.
And that attacking mindset. When Culver sees an opportunity like that, he just grabs it.
Here's George. Knocks it loose. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by George. Minnesota leading by three. Now two. Kicks it to Towns. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Culver. And good. Back to friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Culver's got 6 points.
In this period, they're feeding him. And he's feeling it.
Here's Leonard. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
You see the power right there from Kawhi. Absorbs contact and able to convert right through it.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. Feel good from Kawhi Leonard.
The NBA champion, finals MVP. Kawhi has done a lot in a short time.
Pass to Culver. Second chance shot, and Towns with the lay-in good. Towns has got his second bucket.
Hustle points. Now, just like any others, that's a great play.
With the teardrop. In the corner, Harrell with it. Beverly against T. Softly drops in the floater.
A shot that Beverly's developed. Once you have the floater, you don't always have to get to the rim.
Passes it to Towns. Lays it up off the glass. Towns has got six.
I like the efficiency here. 3 out of 4 shooting, just taking what the defense gives him.
And the pass to Leonard. That's tipped. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. Outside, George. Over in the corner, Beverly. Just 4 to shoot. Over Teague. And it's Beverly missing. And it's Towns with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. 4-point game. Knocked away. Stolen by Beverly. Lays it in off the breakaway.
always applying the pressure. Beverly loves to attack you defensively and in transition.
Culver dishes to T. He kicks to Covington. 6 on the shot clock. Pass to Vonleh. And there's the call on Patrick Beverly. That's foul number 2 for him.
The question is, do you leave him in? Obviously, you don't want him to pick up a third foul this early.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Bally's checked in for Noah Vonleh. Andrew Wiggins comes in for Robert Covington. And Okogie subbed in for Culver. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Zubac is checked in for Montrezl Harrell. Wiggins drives in. And the rejection by Zubac. Nobody near Williams. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. Teague against George. Towns kicks to Bell. He dishes it to Wiggins. It's hauled in by Zubac. The Clippers trail. Here's George. Good. The nice assist for Williams. George has got 5.
And the mid-range jumper really right in George's comfort zone. When he isn't blowing by guys and finishing at the rim, he's knocking that one down with consistency.
Beverly with the ball. Kicks it to Lennon. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's going to be on Andrew Wiggins.
The dribble drive, yet another tool in Leonard's extensive arsenal, earns him a trip to the line.
And these are his 2nd and 3rd free throws tonight. One falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Jang, he's checked in for Karl Anthony Towns. And Jake Layman subbed in for T. The Clippers also making some changes. Green, he's checked in for George. And Landry Shamet subbed in for Patrick Beverly. Leonard hits them both.
He's living there tonight, a tough guy to guard without fouling. And the bonus, he's going to knock him down.
Timeout called, first of the game for Minnesota.
Well, let's see if Coach can get them back on the right track.
Because right now, it feels like the pace is being dictated to them. They need to go back to playing their brand of basketball.
Harkless is checked in for the Clippers. Minnesota with the ball, trailing by 2. To Okogie. Williams against Wiggins. Passes it to Jang. The high post shot. And the rejection by Zubac. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Williams against Wiggins. It's Williams with the drive. The quick look, no good that time. For Minnesota, they've gone 7 of 15 from the field to this point. Wiggins surveying the floor. Here's Jang. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket. It's stolen by Bell. Here's Okogie. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Get that weak stuff out of here. That's embarrassing.
And that one's good, Shamet.
Great timing. That can be the difference between an assist and a turnover.
Here's Okogie. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Wiggins passes to Layman. Three-pointer. The shot missing. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. To the paint and stolen by Jang. Here's Bell, and he jams it with authority.
We've talked about it. Be ready when your number is called. Bell brings a lot of activity.
Wiggins against Williams. Beyond the arc. Rebound by Jang.
And a bump this quarter. He's trying to shoot his way out of it.
The pass to Okogie. Here's Lehman, defended by Harkless. Lehman pass to Wiggins. Four on the shot clock. Over Williams. And it's Wiggins missing. And so it's Williams who brings it up for Los Angeles. Harkless finds Williams. Now Shamet. Now here's Zubats. Pass to Williams. That one good for two. And the Clippers lead by four.
Because of his size, everyone tries to get physical with Luke, but he pays it no mind.
Here's Lehman. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Here's Wiggins. Great touch on the 16-footer. Los Angeles is gone. Just 1-of-4 from three-point range here in the first. Here's Williams. Rebound Minnesota.
His inability to make shots has not brought this team down. That shows you their resourcefulness.
And Los Angeles guys shooting 45% from the field early. Bounce pass from Shamet. Outside Williams. It's deflected. There's Okogie. He's covered by Shamet. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more. Minnesota shooting their third free throw attempt of the game. Josh Okogie. On the free throw, no good. Clippers with the ball. Here's Williams. He scores with that shot. Now he's 3 of 8.
Good recognition by Lou. Sees a crack in the defense, has the speed to exploit it.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And the basket by Okogie. And here is Williams. 6 points for him. On the clock. Shamet on the wing. Over Wiggins. Cans the shot from the wing. Shamet's got his second basket.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Los Angeles on top, up by two. And we'll get it going after this from the Target Center. One of the most high-powered scorers in the game, Karl Anthony Towns, knows it's important to keep his teammates involved.
You know, everyone has to get some of the sugar, you know, so making sure you're not just being a ball hog. So I'm just always trying to make sure that I'm taking wide-open shots that I think everyone on the team would love for me to take if I have the opportunity. But also at the end of the day, making sure everyone gets a chance to be in the candy shop.
Well, when you're attracting, Greg, all that defensive attention, it creates opportunities for your teammates.
And Towns wants to win big. To do that, though, it's not enough to get numbers. You've got to make your teammates better as well.
And we're ready to get back into the action here in game one. Let's see what this quarter has in store for us. And taking a look at Los Angeles' performance here, what have they been doing or not doing?
I love their effort, contesting shots, trying to intimidate here early on. And you
you can see it's already having an impact. It can cause shooters to think twice.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Williams and Shamet are the guard set. Green is out there with Ivica Zubac. And it's Harkless in at the small forward. Now, here's Shamet, covered by Wiggins. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. They now take the lead. Okogie's got 7 points.
The defense decides to gamble off him, and he cashes in.
Now Williams. He's got 6. Pass to Shamet. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Yeah, nice strong finish there. Nearly a 3-point opportunity.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. Free throw good from Shamet. Robert Covington checked in for the Timberwolves. Culver comes in for Josh Okogie. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for the Clippers. Patrick Beverley comes in for Lou Williams. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. Minnesota in the lead. Culver passes to Covington. Passes it to Wiggins. Wiggins drawing the double team. Covington wide open. He fires. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins. Wiggins has got his 3rd assist on the night. Now here's Beverly. Not a lot of room. And again, no good by the Clippers. Timberwolves leading by 4. Quarter 2 and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Culver passes to Wiggins. Lets it go with a 3. The pass to Culver. Outside, Covington. Pass to Wiggins. And looks like the illegal pick was set. Yep, that's right. That'll get their attention.
And guys, point of emphasis for the league is to really crack down on illegal screens.
Yes, the last few years, the rules changes have tended to benefit the offenses. This evens things out a bit.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Towns, he's checked in for Jen. Vonleh comes in for Jordan Bell. And it's Teagan for Andrew Wiggins. Back to Beverly. Loads it up there for Harrell. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Teague drives in. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Well, when Teague has a step or two on the drive, he'll shield the ball and do his best to draw contact.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Taking 2 shots.
And the first one at the line is good. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Everly with the ball. Pass to Shamet. Outside Leonard. Conley with the rebound. Conley's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Teague against Beverly. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Well, Teague is just so elusive on the court that he'll catch you leaning and force you to pick up a foul.
And this is his third trip to the line tonight. And he makes the first.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
And so T gets two free throws.
And it took them a while to find their touch at the line, but they have been red hot here in the second quarter.
In the corner, George with it. Tipped away. And he uses the glass on the lane. George has got 7 points in the game.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Teague, the pass to Towns. Conley, good, and the assist goes to Towns. Conley's got the lead up to 8 now for Minnesota.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
That one drops for him.
The high release point on Kawhi's shot, not much more the defender could do there.
Towns up top. He kicks it to Culver. A floater. And a Shamet with the rebound. Clippers trail by 6. Karl Anthony Towns with the rebound. Towns has got 4 rebounds in this game. Now, here's Culver. He has 6. Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession. Timberwolves leading by 6. Towns kicks to Vonleh. Culver dishes to Teague. Pass to Towns. And the basket for the 4th time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6.
And from day one, Towns has been one of the NBA's top post players. A versatile, well-rounded game on the low block. It doesn't hurt that he can step outside and knock down the jumper either.
Some guys just understand how to generate points. He's one of them.
Outside T. Kicks it to Covington. Let's a floater go.
And for a big guy, Harrell's quick off his feet. He can block shots inside and on the perimeter.
Here's Beverly. And the call will be against Jeff Teague. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Beverly, the pass to Leonard. Lob pass to George. Covington with the steal.
Great job preventing that ball from coming into the post. Might have been an easy 2 if the defense wasn't there.
Clippers trail by 7. Outside, George. And there's the pass to Leonard. Rebound, Minnesota.
You like that he's still attacking, but the results tonight just haven't been there.
And now the fast break. George with the ball.
And hustle paying off there for George in the open court. Gets up court in a flash and finishes before the D can even react.
Culver passes to Vonleh, and the dunk by Vonleh.
Never a bad idea to run the old pick play.
You're right. And if it produces a slam like that, we'll probably see more of them.
Especially if the defense is going to allow you to do it. Have to switch on that play.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. You look at Towns, he's really been playing well.
You know, he's been a one-man record crew down low. His consistent scoring has dictated the pace of this game. We'll see if they decide to front him, bring a quick double, or maybe even both to try to slow him down.
George lets the three fly. A rebound by the Timberwolves. Vonleh's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Deflects the pass. Stolen by George. And pushing it up. Here's Los Angeles. Leonard's got the ball.
The power, the length, the ability to finish. Leonard dominant in that painted area.
And here is Teague. 6 points for him. Pass to Vonleh. Trying to find Towns. Gets it to him.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Beverly finds Shemp. Now here's Leonard. Defense right on him. And he converts the layup. Leonard's got six here in this quarter.
A beast on the dribble drive. You see Kawhi right there, undeterred by contact.
Here's Towns. Over Harrell. And it's Towns missing.
I like it. That's a great battle at the rim.
He just... Ooh! That's how you attack. Wow.
Agree. Well, we know Leonard's an elite two-way machine. But there he shows us the artistry.
And so Beverly will bring it up for Los Angeles. It's a three-point game. Pass to Harrell. And Leonard has it in the corner. Clock at six. Shoots over Covington. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
Here in the second quarter, he's looking much more comfortable with his offense.
Minnesota calls timeout.
And coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
Group substitution now for Minnesota. Jordan Bell's checked in for Noah Vonleh. Jake Lehman comes in for Robert Covington. Okogie's checked in for Culver. And Wiggins is subbed in for Jeff Teague. The Clippers also making some changes. Zubac is checked in for Montrezl Harrell. Green comes in for Landry Shamet. And it's Williams in for Patrick Beverley.
Defensively, you have to tighten up on him or suffer the consequences.
Here's George. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That one is on Towns.
Even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Clippers shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight. First free throw is good.
They've hit every one of their free throws here in the second quarter. Very important when you're trailing.
And George drops them both.
Boy, he's got a great stroke from the line. That's not something we can say about all the league's big guys.
Out to the right wing. Zubats against Towns. And the rejection by Zubats. A second chance effort. Bell against Green. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. Gorgui Dang's checked in for Towns. Maurice Harkless is checked in for the Clippers. And the Clippers have possession, trailing by two. Outside Williams. Dishes it to Harkless.
2 minutes, 2 minutes remaining in the quarter.
And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
First trip to the line for him here. First one falls. He hits one and misses one, each at the line.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
Here's Okogie, and he banks in the layup. Okogie's got 5 points now this quarter.
Wow, he doesn't make plays like that very often. That's a nice move inside.
1:32 left in the first half. Williams looking over the floor. Steps back and shoots. A rebound by the Timberwolves. Jang's got 5 rebounds tonight. Here's Okogie. He's got 9. Here's Bell. Green with the rebound. Clippers trail by 3. Puts it up from 17. The shot by Harkless, no good. Minnesota's gone 3-7 tonight from 3-point territory. Here's Okogie. He's guarded by Williams. Okogie misses. Outside Williams. Passes it to Zubats. Outside George. 5 to shoot. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Yeah, exceptional play there to take the bump and still get it to fall.
This will be his 3rd free throw shot of the game. And it's tied up with that one.
He's in attack mode, drawing contact now, getting to the line, something he didn't do at all in the first quarter.
5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Lehman. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Shot clock at 6. Inside. And it's Wiggins missing.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
He is so comfortable in this area, something Williams relies on, the mid-range.
Paul George, he's been the guy making things happen for Los Angeles. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. And we'll be right back after this.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, y'all. We're reporting to you live here in this sold-out arena. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. Well, for the Clippers, they've hung tough in what was a closely contested first half. If what we've seen in Game 1 so far is any indication, we're going to have quite a series on our hands. And taking a look at the Clippers, Kenny, what did you see out there?
Well, it's always a little bit of a challenge playing on the road, but they came in mentally prepared and physically prepared. The energy in the arena was fierce, but they didn't cave in.
How about you, Shaq? What'd you think about Minnesota?
When you think about giving up three or four extra turnovers, that can mean 8 or 9 points at the other end. That's why every coach preaches it. Take care of the basketball. Bottom line, they need to protect the ball and play under control.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See you, everybody, with Kevin Harlan.
And we welcome you back to 2K Sports coverage of the Western Conference Semifinals. You look at Paul George in this game, guys, he's been everywhere.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. The tandem at the one and the two, Teague and Culver. Conley and Towns, the duo inside. And it's Covington in at the three spot. That's the group starting the second half for Ryan Saunders. Good work there as it goes. Towns has got the game tied up here for the Timberwolves.
Yeah, he's in such a great rhythm right now. Makes sense to get him the ball any way you can.
Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
The pass to Covington, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. For Minnesota, they have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
Covington at the line for two.
And he knocks down the first one. And both free throws good for Covington. And it's Williams with the ball for the Los Angeles Clippers. A 2-point game. Leonard on the wing. In for his seventh make in 14 tries.
He's a bona fide star. Kawhi Leonard with the workmanlike approach.
T kicks to Covington. Towns down low. He's defended by Hill. And here's Covington from the arc. Good, and his assist goes to Towns. Towns has got 3 assists tonight.
Have to guard Covington at all times from outside the arc. He is lethal from deep.
And the call will be against Jeff Teague. And that'll be his 3rd foul so far. And we're about a minute and a half here into the second half. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a 3-point play. Going to the line for one.
They are just killing them on the interior.
For Los Angeles, they have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Now Culver, 6 points for him. That one goes in. Culver's got 8 points.
Terrific game plan coming out of halftime. A perfect 3-for-3 from the field.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. To the middle. Loads it up there for Harrell. An emphatic LU jam.
It's amazing everything Leonard gives you, including the eyes to find the open man.
Culver with it. He's against Williams. Culver's shot is off.
After hitting three straight, they finally missed one. But you can see the rhythm coming out of the half.
And Leonard gets it to go.
Oh, wow. 4 of 5 to start the half. Coming out on fire.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. And Towns throws it down.
Just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. It's George on the wing. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Williams has got 3 assists now in this one.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Teague against Beverly. To the inside, Towns, and the dunk by Towns.
Oh, an aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Here's Leonard. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Leonard's got 6 points in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Towns. Pass to Culver. Six to shoot. Minnesota needs to get off a shot here. That shot off the mark. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Teague against Leonard. Over Teague. And it's the Clippers scoring again.
Well, you know, the truth is Leonard's been focused all night. Has an array of go-to moves and the endurance to keep on coming.
Poked loose. Teague, the pass to Covington. Pass to Culver. From deep three-point range, he is hauled in by Los Angeles.
I'm not sure if anyone on the team has the green light from there. Definitely not him.
It's the kind of shot that gives Hero Ball a bad name and causes your coach to consider another line of work.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Minnesota calls timeout.
And coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
Landry Shamet's checked in for Williams. Culver with it. He's got 8. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And credit the aggressiveness there. I love it whenever Culver is looking to score. It focuses the defense on him and still able to get the job done.
First one falls for.
And Culver's game just screams potential. Already a good scorer, rebounder, and passer. Now the next step, improving that outside shot.
And he makes both free throws.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
Clippers leading by four. Passes to Harrell. Back to George. Outside Leonard. And it's Noah Vonleh with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Jordan Bell comes in for Noah Vonleh. And Andrew Wiggins is subbed in for Robert Covington. Here's George, and it's Paul George with the finish.
And guys, when George gets cooking, you are in for a long night. He's just fantastic at finding different ways to score.
Here's Culver, and the rejection by Harrell. Here's Shamet, fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight. Minnesota making a switch here. Okogie's checked in. Zubats is checked in for the Clippers. Jermichael Green comes in for George. That free throw good from Shamet. Timberwolves trail by nine. Now here's Teague. He's got six. The pass to Bell. The dish to Wiggins. From 11 feet away, it's hauled in by Zubats.
I'm not sure the defense affected that shot. That was just a blown gimme.
Any chance you get, you want to put yourself in a position to succeed, and that's what he did there.
Great job of reading the floor, got to the rim, and made a play.
And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, I love how Teague was able to shield off the defender and still go up and finish for a chance at the three-point play.
This will make four trips to the line so far in the game. Free throw, good team. And here's Beverly. He brings it up for Los Angeles. Pass to Leonard. Shoots from eight. Good. He hits the jump shot. Leonard's got 10 points in the quarter.
I love that they're continuing to attack despite being up big.
I'm impressed with their intensity tonight. They've came in focused, and they've executed.
Leonard draws the double. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Common occurrence for Leonard. Once he makes his way to the rim, Kawhi levels up.
Pass to Okogie. Passes it to Wiggins. Shoots over Shamet. Lock at six. Yep, it goes. And the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 10 points with that basket from Andrew Wiggins. The Clippers shooting a tremendous 61% from the floor, hitting at all cylinders. Beverly against T. And Beverly kicks to Green. Shamet again, the Clippers.
I can't believe that went in, and I don't think he can either.
Minnesota calls timeout.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question, toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Jang, he's checked in for Karl-Anthony Towns. And Jake Lehman subbed in for T. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Harkless has checked in. Lehman passed to Jang. Now here's Wiggins. Defended by Harkless. Wiggins dishes to Jang. Here's Okogie. He's covered by Leonard. Clippers leading by 12. Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. And there's the pass to Zubats. Outside, Green. Pass to Beverly. From deep. As they get it back. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Patrick Beverly is an irritant. You hate playing against him. Love playing with him.
It's his first trip to the line. And the first one drops.
Patrick Beverly is a tone setter, someone who doesn't back down from anyone. I admire his confidence.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Culver's checked in. George has checked in for the Clippers. Both free throws good from Beverly. Timberwolves trail by 16. Pass to Wiggins. Now Jang, defended by Harkless. Jang finds Wiggins. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Shooting for Minnesota, Andrew Wiggins at the line for two.
That free throw missing. Carl Anthony Towns checked in for Minnesota. He's off on the second. Clippers leading by 16. And here is Harkless. Here's George. Los Angeles with another miss. Passes it to Okogie. It's hauled in by the Clippers. George passes to Harkless. He feeds it to Green. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. On the wing, Wiggins. Kicks it to Culver. Here's Okogie. 9 points in the game so far. Four on the clock. Here's Wiggins, and it's good. The time running down in the shot clock. Wiggins has got 11 points.
When you have space like he did there, you never go with the fadeaway jumper. He has to attack the rim next time.
And it's George finishing it off.
You see the athleticism George had on that dunk. So quick and explosive. Gets to the rim in an instant.
Feeds to Towns. Green with the block. And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. And it's the Clippers with the ball. And here's Beverly. He brings it up for Los Angeles. 16-point lead, the largest margin in the game.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Minnesota's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum. And not relying at all on the three-point shot. They may want to rethink about stretching the defense a bit like they did in that first half.
Now the pass to Green. He dishes it to George. George double team. Green kicks to George. Six on the shot clock. Takes the three. It's rebounded by Towns. Towns has got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
He had 6 points from long range in the first half, but nothing's fallen here since.
Beautiful location on the pass, as usual. Led his man perfectly.
6 second difference between shot and game clock. George double teamed. Here's Zubats. The shot's good on the assist by George. Zubats has got his first basket.
And the feed from George couldn't be better. The timing, the placement, everything about that dish was pinpoint.
Inside, Towns, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
That's a well-timed, well-coordinated play. Comes right off the pick for the lay-in.
George, that's a two-pointer, and no good in the last-second attempt this time. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Clippers lead by 14. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
Fundamental basketball. Keep your eyes up. Keep the ball moving. You're going to keep the defense on its heels.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the fourth, Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. Paul George is out there with Green, and it's Zubats in at the five spot. Beverly finds Green. Off the mark there with a three-point shot.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Culver passes to Wiggins. And here's Culver, guarded by Green. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. That one's good, and the Clipper lead has cut down to just 12 points on the bucket from Towns.
He's doing what he can do to pull them closer, but it's not enough. He needs more help.
Pass to Zubats. Back to Williams. Kicks to George. To the right side. And that one's good. Beverly. And the Clippers lead by 14.
I like seeing Patrick Beverly attack the interior. Sometimes he becomes too perimeter-oriented.
Akogi, the pass to Wiggins. Culver with it. Williams comes with the double team. Here's Akogi. No good with the triple. Just about 1.5 minutes gone by here in the fourth. Outside Williams. Pass to George. George double teamed. Back to Williams. Fires for three. But they recover it. Here's Zubats. That shot misses. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Efficient performance from him. Not the case for everyone else on his team.
Outside, George fires the three. Rebound by Akogi.
There was a mix-up defensively. Left him all alone. He just couldn't hit it.
And really, the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
At the line for your Timberwolves, Josh Akogi. At the line for two.
And he knocks down the first one. Noah Vonleh, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Teague comes in for Culver. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Jermichael Green. He hits both from the stripe. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Outside, George passes to Williams. It's rebounded by Towns. Towns has got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Covington finds Towns. And the pass to Teague. From deep three-point range, kept alive, Minnesota. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. That's his second
first half. Shooting for Minnesota, Noah Vonleh. At the line for two.
And he makes the first. Los Angeles making a switch here. Leonard's checked in. Both shots good from the stripe. Los Angeles leading by eight. Harold trying to free himself up, and it's Leonard with the jam.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury.
He rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
And stolen by Harold. Everly with the ball. Picked up by Teague. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. And the Clippers lead by 12.
These are big buckets. He's been instrumental in helping them try to close out this game.
And there's the call on Montrezl Harrell. That'll be his second foul of the game. On defense, the Clippers. Vonleh. Just five on the clock. Takes a three.
Beautiful contest there by one of the most tenacious defenders in the game, Patrick Beverly.
It's George on the wing. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. George has got 15 points here in the second half.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
Here's Towns, and the layup's good off the glass.
Playing from behind right here, not easy, but he is answering the bell.
The reason why is not just scoring, it's the way he's doing it. Efficient. That's what you need at this point in the game.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, during that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what Doc Rivers said to his team. He said, keep grinding. We're in good shape. Things aren't always going to go perfect. Don't let that slow you down. Let's just stick to what got us here. Kevin, we'll see if they can build on this lead.
Thank you, David.
I mean, a dunk machine dating back to high school. Montrezl Harrell is an absolute monster around the rim.
And it's Towns missing.
And his pure defensive effort changed that shot from an easy one to a tough one.
And you know, technically, it's a high percentage look, but this is why we play the game.
Harold dishes to George. Towns against Harold. Back to George. From the arc, drills the three-pointer. George has got 35.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Yeah, he just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. The 10-footer. Here's Harrell, and a good offensive board, and he gets the bucket. And the Clippers lead by 17.
And that's the battle. They haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
and the rejection by Harrell. And now running up the court, Leonard
pushes. And you see Kawhi's hustle in transition, always putting himself in position to succeed.
Pass to Towns. Back to Teague. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Towns kicks the tee. Six to shoot. There's another block.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's six blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. The feed to Beverly. Good. The nice assist for Williams. Williams has got his sixth assist on the night. Timberwolves trail by 21. Down low is Van Lane. Rebound, Kawhi Leonard. Leonard's got his fifth rebound in this one. On the wing, George. Back to Leonard. George finds Leonard over T. Nice spin off the left rim and in. And it's 37 points for Kawhi Leonard.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Okogie, the pass to Towns. Teague surveying the D. To the left side wing. For three, Okogie. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
He's been of no help stretching the floor tonight. Just one three in the first half. Nothing in the second.
And they're getting points. They're getting stops. And this is how they'd like to play all the time.
Yes, when it's going good, it feels easy. These are the nights you relish, but they're tough to replicate.
Here's Teague, and it's wide right, hits off the rim.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Pass to Beverly. Harrell against Towns. Outside, George. Here's Harrell. That falls. Nice speed that time from George. George has got three assists now in this one. Minnesota's gone ice cold from three-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. Beverly against T. And the rejection by Harrell. Leonard draws the double to the paint. And Harrell slams it in.
It's impressive, the level of domination at both ends, and you're seeing the results.
Especially considering it's on the road in front of a tough crowd. They've been able to block out the distractions.
Passes it to Vonleh. Here's Okogie. He's covered by Leonard. Trying to end the drought. And the basket by Okogie. Okogie's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Not just selling for something along the perimeter. Excellent job. Yo,
who's man is Paul? Outside Leonard. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It goes on Noah Vonleh.
Good job inviting contact. The closer Leonard gets to the rim, the more dangerous he becomes.
And the first one at the line is good.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Whole new look on the floor for Minnesota. Leonard hits them both. And so Napier will bring it up for Minnesota. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Yeah, easy call.
Shooting for Minnesota.
Shabazz Napier. Two shots.
Free throw drops for Napier. He makes one of two that time. Los Angeles has gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. The pass to Cabangeli. Back to Robinson. Outside Leonard. Leonard draws the double. Pocket four. Puts up a three. And it's Magruder missing. Minnesota's gone ice cold from three-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. And finished off by Graham.
Great job executing the offense. That pass on time and on point.
They've shared the load offensively.
And guys, they put the defense on their heels. You can see right now they're trying to react. And that's what you want when you're in a rhythm offensively.
Here's Lehman. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Lehman's got his first 2 points of the night.
And what started it all, terrific anticipation on the defensive end.
Most teams now are looking to play with pace. No better way to ignite the break than off a turnover.
And that's just cold-blooded right there. He's taking no prisoners.
Expanding upon this league, trying to close it out. He's really stepped up.
And Leonard, no good on that one. Minnesota shooting at 46%, making some buckets.
And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the Clippers.
They really lit it up in this one. Fantastic offensive performance.
Definitely. Just simply shot the ball well. One of those games to be proud of.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Leonard.
Shouldering the load for them all night offensively. He came in focused, ready to go, and he delivered.
Here's Bates Diop, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That's on Patrick Patterson.
At the line for your Timberwolves, Keita Bates Chop, taking two shots.
The first free throw is good. Landry Shamet checked in for the Clippers. And so he hits both. 55 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Pass to Patterson. Fader on the way. Count the basket.
They just blocked out the noise, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
And guess what? It's going to be a fun flight home. Total team effort. Big win on the road.
Napier passes to Jang. And it's blocked. Pass to Shamet. Shot and game clock separated by five.
Patterson.
Here's Cabangeli. Jang defending. Pass to Shamet. Shot clock at five. It's hauled in by Bates Diop. That's it. They've won the series. And you got to feel good about getting each and every game here in the postseason.
You know, Kevin, each game is just so significant and magnified. This has got to feel really good.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Paul. Outstanding game tonight. And I always wonder what it's like when you really are feeling good out there and how that shows up on the floor.
Man, this got to be one of the best games I've played. It just seemed like I couldn't miss. And my teammates found me. They made it easy for me. And, you know, shots finally fell for me.
Yes, I know that phrase is in the zone. It looked like you were living there tonight. Thanks, Paul. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. Well, that'll do it, folks. Glad you could join us for the Western Conference Semifinals. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.